The Jackery Explorer 1500 Ultra is an all-new design. It's marketed as one of their most toughest power stations yet. It's got an IP65 rating for dust and water. It's got a level 9 seismic shockproof rating. Not so sure about that one. And they claim it can withstand a 1 meter drop with its all-new rugged construction. So, as long as this power station can perform the way you'd expect it to, it might just be the perfect all-new 1500 watt-hour power station. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Jackery is an OG in the power station industry, but they rarely make units that wow us. They're all great power stations and they all work really well, but it's nice to have that wow factor every once in a while. So when we first saw that Jackery was releasing this thing, we were quite excited because it looks, at least how they market it, like it might just be an exciting unit. As always, we will leave links to this unit as well as any discount codes that we can get from Jackery for you guys in the description down below. We'll also leave our power station quiz, so if you're not entirely sure what power station is best for you, you can take the quiz, it takes 30 seconds, gives you an instant recommendation. But before we get into all of the good, the new, and the bad with the Jackery Explorer 1500 Ultra, we're gonna hit you guys with a super quick spec teardown in case you're not already familiar with this all new unit. So first up, this passes the tiny baby lift test. It only weighs about 38.6 pounds. It's got a 1,536 watt hour battery bank built in, and it is not expandable. It's paired with an 1800 watt inverter. And when it comes to getting power into this guy, you can charge it with a regular house outlet in your home at about 1800 watts, or with solar at about 800 watts. In terms of the plugs and ports on this guy, you have 320 volt house plugs right here on the front. You have two USB-Cs and one USB-A. The USB-C, one of them is only a 30 watt, the other one is at least 100 watt. Over here you have your 12 volt car socket, which is nice that it retained that. And then this flap right here is all of your inputs. So this is where you'd actually put AC in and your two solar in connections. There's two 400 solar connections. It's not just one 800. But that's it for plugs and ports. And in terms of the all new design, it still has classic Jackery handle up top. I personally think that this new look is weird. To me, it kind of feels like it came straight from Temu, but that's just my opinion. Health and Safety loves it. He thinks it looks durable and rugged and way better than Jackery used to. So I guess that's just kind of a matter of opinion thing, but it seems like based on another new release, this is kind of the way they're gonna go with their units. So hopefully it grows on me. The screen is typical Jackery screen. It's easy to read, it's bright, it shows you the basics. The app is classic Jackery app. It lets you turn things on and off from afar, update the unit, do a couple things you can't do directly from the unit, but nothing crazy. And right now, the retail price on this thing is $899. If we can get a discount code from Jackery, we will leave it in the description down below to help save you guys a little bit of money. So the first thing that we like about the 1500 Ultra is that all of the new features that they advertised are legit. We dropped this thing from over a meter multiple times and it has survived all of the drops. We actually have a second one that we abused the crap out of. That's why this one has no scuffs on it. We dropped it literally just from a meter straight onto concrete. And then we also simulated like if you had it in the bed of your truck and you were pulling something out and you accidentally knock it off the tailgate, a couple different scenarios and it lived every time. It still works great. You can go ahead and remove the bottom to clean the fans out a little bit and it actually works. Like you can clean the fans while they're running. I don't recommend that, but it is waterproof. It's not gonna destroy the unit if you go ahead and actually hose this thing down. It seems to be pretty waterproof. We sprayed it with a hose. These flaps do a good job of keeping everything shielded. Even when they're open, they actually seal across the top. So if you have things plugged in, this actually creates a little bit of a roof and it doesn't allow water to kind of come in from the top and get at your plugs. Overall, everything Jackery advertised, we tested, except the level 9 seismic shock proof. Like, yeah, it works, you know?
Like, we'd have to go to San Francisco across our fingers.
We like that, you know? They could easily have said it drops from a meter and it exploded when we tried. We also like that this unit is very quiet. Typically, Jackery has always had fans on both sides, passing air straight through the unit. The new design on this, where you actually have the fan built right here in the bottom, and then it's got the cooling fins all around the fan, is actually a really good design. It seems to dissipate heat really well. It's been a while since we've had a Jackery. I don't think we've ever had a Jackery unit that is this quiet.
Or it's formed by a landslide.
Level 9 shock, landslide. Coming back to the design a little bit, we do like, aside from all of their new stuff, that it did retain the handle. This is a very nice handle from Jackery. It makes picking this thing up super easy. It has grippier rubber feet than normal. A lot of power stations, when you go to put a plug into them, you actually just slide them across the table. This one, the feet actually do a good job of gripping the crown. And we like that it retained a 12-volt car socket. A lot of units are getting away from this, but if you're gonna take this camping or if you have any real accessories, a lot of them use 12-volt car sockets. So it's nice that this unit still has that. And the last and probably biggest thing with this power station is that when in our testing, it performed super, super good. This power station was 98% efficient. That's higher than any power station we have ever seen here at the lab, ever. I personally think it's because it doesn't have such needy fans. I think most power stations, when they're running at a high load, they lose a lot of power to the fans, which are trying to keep it cool. This one, the fan doesn't have to run that hard because it's underneath, basically dissipating the heat over all of the fins. I don't know, at first I wasn't sold on that whole design. I thought I wasn't sure how it was gonna work. But after the results in our testing, I think it's actually a really good design and it probably is what's making this unit so efficient. In terms of charging, it went from zero to full in an hour and 21 minutes in our testing, which is pretty good. Usually we don't talk about surging because a lot of power stations really don't surge, but this one actually went ahead and surged higher than its rated output at 3,600 watts, no problem, which is pretty good. And in terms of idle consumption, if you just had the AC inverter on and it was just sitting there doing nothing but idling, waiting for you to come up and plug something into it, it used about 21 watts every hour just sitting there on, which is a little higher than some other units, but you still get about 3 days of idle consumption with this unit, which is not that bad. And the solar input is good. It works really well. And then it pairs really nicely with Jackery's 400 watt. First thing we don't like about this power station though is that it doesn't have a light on it. Jackery was one of the only brands that you could rely on giving you a light on a power station, and they took it away with this new design, which we don't like. These are designed to be used camping or on the go or even just for home backup. If you have this in your basement and the power goes out, you have to pick it up and walk it around and also hold a light. If you just had a light on this, you could see where you were going using the power station. And so it's kind of disappointing that Jackery went ahead and took the lights off of this. They did give you light up buttons, which health and safety was pretty fired up about. The only issue with these is that when they're off, they don't light up. You can't find the unit just because the buttons are there. Pecron, for example, the buttons glow in the dark. So once it goes in the dark, you could still see the button. You could press it really easy to turn it on. You don't actually need a light in your hand. Little things, they sound dumb, but they make a big difference. The other thing we noticed is that even though the new metal base of this power station is pretty cool and it does clean out very well, and the whole point is that you can remove it, clean it and put it back, it does lend itself nicely to becoming a problem. Now all of your ventilation is around the base. So like if you were to take this to the beach or camping and you just put it on the dirt or even a job site and it's just sitting on the ground, all the dust that accumulates around it is gonna get sucked up into here. Yeah, it's nice that you could take the base off and wash it out, but if it didn't have that design, you wouldn't have to take the base off and wash it out. That's just something to know, is that depending on where you're gonna use this, you might find that actually becomes a problem. And the last thing that we didn't like is kind of more techie. It's probably more related just to us because we test a lot of power stations, but this thing says it charges at 1800 watts and it has a fast charging mode. A lot of other brands, when you press fast charging, it will say, hey, charging at high speeds may hurt your battery, whatever, do you accept? You hit yes, and it will charge super fast. This is a 1500 watt hour battery. It can charge at 1800 watts. The fastest it will charge in fast charging mode is like an hour and 20 minutes, which is still pretty good. Like there's nothing wrong with that time, but we've seen other brands where if you say yes, charge fast, it will charge in, like in this case, it would be like 40 minutes. So it's not a big deal, but there's still like a 40 minute delay. If you're like, oh, I forgot to charge this thing before we go camping, it's a pretty big difference between 40 minutes and an hour and 20 minutes when you're sitting around waiting for this thing to charge up. So at the end of the day, who is this power station for? We think this is a really good entry point for light home backup. If you're trying to have something for when the power goes out, you can run most appliances in your home with a power station like this, and it will last a decent amount of time. Like you could run your fridge for over a day with this power station, and you could run all the other small appliances off of this unit, no problem. And as with Jackery's other units, this is great for camping, overlanding, that kind of thing. As long as you're not putting it directly in sand, you shouldn't have much of a problem with it. It's a little more weather rated than their old ones, which again is just very nice for people that are taking it camping and overlanding. We would recommend it. We think it's a great unit. It did perform well. It was pretty durable, but let us know what you guys think. Otherwise, that's pretty much all we got for you guys today. If we can get any coupons from Jackery, they will be below. The quiz will be below. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you guys do that. Otherwise, we will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.